Bande Guru Padottandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nityananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Bande Radhika Charanodayam Gopijano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manoharam Vāñcha-kalpa-taru-vaśya-kipāsindu-bhyavacu Patitānaṁ pāvune-bhavaiṣṇave-bhyo-namo-namah Mūkaṁ karoti-vācālaṁ pangunglaṁ haitikidam Yat-kipātam-ahang-bandhi-paramānanda-mādavu Vindāvai-tulsi-debvai-piyāvai-kesava-sacha Śrīna-bhakti-pade-devi-sattva-vatvai-namo-namah Narayana namaskitta naram chaiva narottamam Devim saraswatim vyasam tato jayo mudire Sankirtane krishna kathopadeshe Gauriya patrasya prakasa necha Sadanurakta guru bhakti yukta Bhakti pramodaksha jagod varunya Deyam sada paribhavagnam avishchaduham Tithas padam siva virinchinutam saranyam Vetatiham panatopal bhavadibhutam Bande mahapurusate charna ravindam Yat pada pallavanaka chandamani chataya Vispurijita kumapigabhavadu swadarshi Purnanuragra sasagra saramurti saradhikamai kada kipam karosh Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Ajanulambita bhujau kanakaha bodhato Sankirtanai kapitaro kamala yutaksho Visham varo dijavaro yugadharma palo Bande jagat priyakaro karuna bhataro Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Ajanulambita bhujau kanaka bodhato Sankirtanai kapitaro kamala yatakshu Visham varo dijavaro yugadharma palo Bande jagat priyakaro karuna bhataro Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Namami Gange Tava Pada Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibha Rupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavan rupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapaharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vagisha jushva vadane लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च बक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। वेणुं कनन्तमरविन्ददलायुताक्षं वरहावतंसमसितां विदुसुन्दराङ्गं कन्दर्पकोटिकमोनियो विशेषशोभं गोविन्दमादिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि। वेणुं कनन्तमरविन्ददलायुताक्षं वरहावतंसमसितां विदुसुन्दराङ्गं कन्दर्पकोटिकमोनियो विशेषशोभं गोविन्दमादिपुरुषं तमहं नमामि तमहं भजामि। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद परमहंस जगद्गुरु टोल्ड, देर इज नो अदर वे ओपन फॉर अस, देर इज नो अदर वे ओपन टू अस एक्सेप्ट टेकिंग शेल्टर अंटू द लोटस फीट ऑफ अ प्राकृत शब्द ब्रह्म। We will have to depend upon that aprakita sabda brahma, aprakita harikatha. This harikatha emanating from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vishnu can make us free from this material clutcher. That is the only way. So our oral reception should be very careful to catch all aprakita sabda brahma. Because people are in confusion about aprakita sabda brahma and material sabda, they have no idea. Aprakita sabda brahma can help us to cut all material bondage and can take us up to Vaikuntha jagat. There is no other way. Prahlad Maharaj crying and speaking in front of Nrisimhadev, there is the only and single way open before us. What is that? We will have to depend upon aprakita sabda brahma. To cut all material bondage and reach you. But I am not developing interest in aprakita harikatha. Naitat mano me tava katha so vaikuntha nath sampriyate durita duksh दुरित दुष्टम असाधु तीव्रम कामातूरम हर्ष शोकम भयेशनार्थम तस्मिन कथम तब गतिम विमिस्वामी दीना। नैतात मनो में तब कथास वैकुंठनाथ संप्रियते दुरित दुष्टम असाधु तीव्रम कामातूरम हर्ष शोक भयेशनार्थम तस्मिन् कथम तव गतिम विमिसामि दीनः। प्रह्लाद महाराज क्राइंग एंड स्पीकिंग, प्रभु हाउ वी कैन रीच यू, हाउ वी कैन गो टू यू, बिकॉज वी आर नॉट डेवलपिंग इंटरेस्ट इन हियरिंग अप्राकृत हरिकथा, वेयर एज दिस इज द ओनली वे टू कट ऑल मटेरियल बॉन्डेज एंड रीच यू, दैट इज ओनली वे। Baba speaking, at present people are really not interested to hear aprakita harikatha. They are interested about material thing. According to their material experience, they like to concentrate in material matters, material interest. What all they heard before, they are actually interested about that. What all they never heard, about that Vaikuntha Katha, they are not developing any interest. So they are all Bhagavad Bahirmukh. They are against Bhagavad Bhajan, Bahirmukh. Mano Rathin Ashato Dhavato Vahi. Those subject matters relating with this material world, they like it. They are feeling interest to hear. They never want to hear what they never heard before. They are less interested to hear about Bhagavad Katha. They don't like. They are running behind Shabda Sparsha Ruparas Gandha. They are running behind Shabda Sparsha Ruparas Gandha, all. And those Shabda Sparsha Ruparas Gandha, can have an influence on them, over them. They are going to, this Shabda Sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandha can get control over this society. So, this Shabda Sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandha, by the order of Mayadevi, going to engage all people in collecting all material enjoyment, material interest, just like a honeybee is going to collect honey from flower. Everybody like to get sensual gratification. Everybody like to get sensual gratification. Who is going to arrange all sensual gratification for me? Who can arrange complete sensual gratification? Complete in the sense they can feel, but still their saturation can never come. Because we are hearing Harikatha, we know, na jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. We know from Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavad Mahapurana. Na jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. Sensual enjoyment cannot help you to get a saturation point. Sensual enjoyment cannot help you to reach one saturation point. Not possible. That's why many documents are there in Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapurana. There it is written, na jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. Hovisha Krishna Batmayo Bhuyo Evavi Bardhate. If we are going to add fuel in the fire, I mean ghee, oil, if we are going to offer ghee in a glowing fire, we cannot expect that the fire can come to a, can be extinguished. We cannot expect. The same thing was spoken by Devahuti Ma. Devahuti Ma wanted to pray unto the lotus feet of Kapilji Maharaj. That I am just fed up. Whatever demand, all my sense organ, whatever demand they wanted to put in front of me, I wanted to supply. But still, up to now, I am not getting any satisfaction. They are merciless. They are not having any compassion on me. So I am just fed up. So you please help me now. I am surrendered unto your lotus feet. You please save me. I am not satisfied. For a long time I am trying to satisfy my sense organ, but not possible. At present, everybody likes to get this kind of sensual gratification. Whatever amount of sensual gratification one can arrange for you, you can like that man accordingly. You can love him. And who is going to speak about the absolute truth, absolute way? standing on absolute platform, you cannot like, you cannot approve. You cannot approve that sadhu. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, people approve people of their own stamp. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, people approve people of their own stamp. They never like to approve you and me. That is the main problem. Actually, if you can reach up to neutral point, if you can reach up to at least a neutral point, you can understand that really people like to jump into fire from frying pan. At present the condition of those conditioned souls, at present the condition of this conditioned soul is that they just like to jump into fire from frying pan. This is not solution. Nirgun Vastu, Paratpar Akhileshwar, can appear in this material world to cut our bondage, to help us to cut our bondage. Nirgun Vastu, Aprakita Bhagavan, Paratpar Akhileshwar, can appear in this material world. Though Bhagavan is beyond any material limit, though Bhagavan is beyond any material limit, Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, we can never control them. If we like to control them, we can go to hell. We can die just. Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan can reserve the right of not being exposed to our sense organ. They have the sole right. Follow. But we like to play our, you know, rationality, intellectual brain, everything to understand the aprakita jagat. Simply one thing they cannot understand, they are blockheaded, that aprakita vastu kobu prakita gochannai. All aprakita vastu can never be understood by the application of material brain, intellect, everything. Never. It's not possible. That's why in Upanishad we know yato vacha nivartante aprappo manushasaha. If we like to apply our manpower, money power, brain power, educational power, we can just come out success, we can come out failure. All our efforts can come to a flop end. Whatever things we are talking here in the material world, all matter. But all those pure devotees, Bhagavad Bhakta, Paramahamsa, Guru Vaishnava, if they are speaking something, it is called aprakita sabda brahma, not material world. Prabhupada speaking, inside this aprakita sabda brahma, Prabhupada speaking, inside this aprakita sabda brahma has some tremendous power. Alaukik. Within the sound there is tremendous power. Supernatural power, alaukik shakti. When Guru Vaishnava speaking Harikatha, inside this sabda brahma there is tremendous supernatural power. And if somebody going to hear with full patience from the lotus mouth of this, you know, great devotees, realized soul, then our degree of consciousness can go up. Then the degree of our consciousness can gradually go up, and ultimately under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava we can reach up to Vaikuntha Jagat. No doubt in it. No doubt in it. But we are less interested. We are less interested. Many people used to put question in front of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. How we can get in touch with Bhagavan? How we can meet with Bhagavan? Gaurakishore Babaji used to say, you will have to cry. You will have to cry from heart as you are crying for children, as you are crying for money, property. You will have to cry. The same thing Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Kirtan. Vishaye je priti eve achoye amaro sei mato priti ho charone tomaro. The kind of attraction, hey Prabhu, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, hey Prabhu, the kind of tremendous attraction I am feeling for matter, the same attraction I like to feel for your lotus feet. That is my prayer, that is my request unto your lotus feet. It is my request unto your lotus feet. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Matter and antimatter, I mean material world and devotional world, cannot persist inside my heart simultaneously. If all material thinkings are there, if all material conception thinkings are there, then surely aprakita bhavana is not there. Mixing procedure is not at all allowed. That's why we are here. That's why that's why we are hearing from Brihad Bhagavatamrita. That's why we are hearing from Brihad Bhagavatamrita that Gopakumar gradually developing dissatisfaction, gradually feeling dissatisfaction because he was made king. I can come to the point. So matter and all Shuddha Bhakti cannot stay together, not possible. That's why Kunti Devi told same thing, janmaishajya suto sivireda mana madaha pamano naiva arhati avidatumai tamakinchana gocharam. You can only be known by a paramahansa niskinchan bhakta. I mean when a jivatma can take shelter of Bhagavan, absolute shelter. When one jivatma can take absolute shelter unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan, then Bhagavan can give response. Many times you are doing kirtan, I am also doing kirtan, but we are not going to pay full attention to this kirtan. There it is written. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing kirtan there. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Siya Dvaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Jive Dayakari Saparshada Siya Dhamo Saho Avotori Atanta Durlabha Prema Karibare Dhano Sikhaya Sarunagati Karo he uttamo, daino atmani vedano, goptitya varano, avasharakhiven Krishna, vishasopalano, bhakti unukulo matro, karjero sikaro, bhakti pratikulo bhavo, varjanangikaro, sarango saranagati haive jaharo taharo parthana sune sinando kumaro. In this kirtan it is written, daino humbleness, daino atma nivedan submission, guptitta varan, Bhagavan can save me anyway. Daino atma nivedan guptitta varan, guptitta varan, avasya rakhiven Krishna vishasa palan. Surely Bhagavan can save me. Bhakti anukul matrukar, Jesus, I am protected by Bhagavan, guptitta, I am always protected by Bhagavan. Any condition coming, no problem. Guptitta varan. Avasya rakhiven Krishna vishasa palan. Bhakti anukul, favorable, which is favorable for bhakti, I can accept. What is not at all favorable for bhakti, I can discard. So all these six kind of condition is called sharanga saranagati. Six fold of saranagati, all six fold of saranagati, if it is satisfied, unto the lotus feet of Krishna, then and only then Krishna can give response. Krishna can give response, otherwise not. Then what is the condition of born-again soul? Those who are half devotee or those doing bhajan, mixing way. For them, there is one procedure. Whatever problem they are facing, whatever difficulties they are facing, they can pray unto the lotus feet of pure devotee, and that pure devotee can apprise, pure devotee can speak in front of Bhagavan. Bhagavan, that is bonded soul, as you cannot do, you please help him, you know. Vaishnavero avedane Krishna dayamay, by the application of pure Vaishnava, Vaishnavero avedane Krishna dayamay, Krishna dayamay, who is full of mercy, ehano pamor papi, ehano pramor prati haiven sadai. I am a fallen soul. If one Vaishnava going to pray unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan on behalf of me, then Bhagavan can adhere, Bhagavan can hear. That is the condition. Vaishnavero avedane Krishna dayamay, ehano pamor prati haiven sadai. That is the procedure. Otherwise, six-fold of saranagati, otherwise, six-fold of saranagati must be there. Otherwise, six-fold of saranagati must be there unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan. Then and only then, Bhagavan can give response to us. Otherwise, no way out, no way out. Actually, people are less interested to take trouble. People, they are busy with physical amenities so much. Physical amenities, they are busy with all physical amenities. Even they are not going to play their head for any addition or multiplication. They are going to take help of calculator or mobile. This is there. I mean, they are not at all ready to take trouble. So how we can expect that they can take trouble to do Hari Bhajan? One example Prabhupada used to give. Prabhupada used to give one example. One boy. And one old lady. Old lady mane? Okay, 50 over almost. That lady never allow his son to go to river to swim. She never liked to allow her son to go to river for swimming. What to speak about swimming? To take bath. Swimming, the question of, you know, practice. Even that lady mother never allow the boy to take bath in river. Because why? But if If my boy going to take bath in river, by chance if my boy drown there, that's why this kind of, you know, anxiety, this kind of tension, that's why never. One day, one very old lady, one day one very old lady came here in front of that mother and speaking, "You gone mad? Why you are not going to allow your son to take bath in river? But by chance he can drown there." No, actually he is now very, you know, small age boy. This is the time to learn swimming. We also in our own life and started learning swimming in young age, very small age. It is that they can practice. After learning swimming, it is not possible to fear water. The old lady going to give some argument. I mean, suppose your boy going, because now he is small boy, someday he can grow up and someday he is supposed to go to some other land here and there, different places. By chance going to cross by the help of a boat. But suppose that boat going to break down and capsize, in that case you cannot get back your son because you are not going to allow your son to learn swim. Oh really? Oh really? After that, the old lady was a little bit ready, agree to allow his son to learn swimming, but without water. Without coming down in water, who can learn swimming? Nobody can learn. But the old lady, you know, suggesting, "Boy, you can learn water, learn, you know, swimming." The small, you know, boy speaking, "Well, I am ready to learn swimming, provided somebody can teach me without going into water. I am ready, I am very much willing to learn swimming, but without going into water, I like to learn. If somebody can help." And the mother also wanted to approve the brain of this boy. Popa speaking, in Haribhajan there is too much trouble. People thinking very difficult. People are very much interested to go to hell, Narak Gulzar. If everybody going to hell, so I can also go. What problem? Majority must be granted. Popa speaking, they are not ready to do Hari Bhajan because in course of Hari Bhajan they will have to suffer. You know, they have to suffer. So they are not at all ready. Rather, they can die in this material world, but still they are not ready to do Hari Bhajan. Because for Hari Bhajan, they will have to go to Guru Griha in the Bhajan Kutir, I mean the temple of Guru Pad Padma. They have to take Diksha, Harinam Diksha. So much rules and regulations, restriction, Vaidya Pranali, which is approved in Shastra, they will have to obey. So they are not going to keep themselves. They are not going to follow this kind of strict rules and regulations. They fear a different kind of hesitation, different kind of anxiety, different kind of fear, you know, different kind of, you know, material baba, they grow inside heart. They are not feeling any inspiration to do Hari Bhajan. If at all somebody can allow Hari Bhajan without undergoing any trouble, scriptural, we can do whatever we like, but still we can do Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. As at present people, at present most of the acharyas allowing this kind of practice. Okay, you can do. Most of them, those acharyas, they are allowing this procedure. Okay, you can do. But Prabhupada speaking, if they are not at all ready to follow scriptural instruction, if at all they are not going to obey Guru Vaishnava, if at all they are less interested to keep themselves under the strict guidance of Guru Vaishnava, how they can do Hari Bhajan? Hari is not a matter of joke. Hari hi nirguno shakshad purusho prakriti parehe. Hari hi nirguno shakshad prakriti pare. Hari is not an object which you can find in the material world. Hari is not such an object which you can find in the material world. Hari hi nirguno shakshad purusho prakriti pare. Sha sarvadrik upadashta tang bhajano nirguno bhavet. Bhagavan is sitting inside heart at super soul. Every jiva, where not, everywhere, Bhagavan. But without following scriptural instruction, without following Guru Vaishnava, who can do Hari Bhajan? Nobody can do. But at present, the system is like that. Everybody can do Hari Bhajan. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we are not at all ready to allow people, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we are not at all ready to allow people to make some urine and stool in Namahatta, Hari Bhajan field. We are less interested. No, we cannot allow. But at present, this is the system. Okay, Maharaj, they can come. Make some urine and stool. And infection can, you know, break down everywhere, break out everywhere. Prabhupada speaking, like this, this is the same example. If somebody not going to jump into water, then how it is possible for somebody to learn swimming? To learn swimming, you will have to jump into water, you have to drink some unexpected water, you will have to drink, and you will have to suffer. And after some day, you can learn swimming, after that no trouble. You can swim and cross over one river, one lake, it's possible, not before that. Here, we are hearing with full attention about Gopukumar, because Gopukumar speaking all about his personal experience of bhajan. In front of that, in Gopukumar going to speak all in details, what all happened in his life, he is going to speak in front of that disciple, who want to submit unto Lotus Feet of Gopukumar, who is coming from Guwahati, Pragjyotishpur, is a Brahmin. And now we discover that Gopukumar finally going to reach Purushottam Dham, and for a long time staying in Purushottam Dham, getting enthusiastic energy to do Hari Bhajan. Especially the darshan of Jagannath Jagadish was a very vital point for him. And just yesterday, due to internet problem, I couldn't speak all in details. Only 45 minutes around. 43 minutes, 45 minutes, they are going to publish. They're going to publish, you know. Because due to internet problem, I couldn't speak. I was not feeling inspiration yesterday. So I like to remind you, Gopakumar finally going to stay in Jagannath Puri for a long time. And one day, as I was speaking yesterday, one day, Gopakumar watching Jagannath Dev, lotus feet of Jagannath, he was concentrating in the darshan Baba. Ultimately, he could discover his Guru Pad Padma, who is missing for a long time. Because Gopakumar took Diksha long ago in Vrindavan at the bank of Jamuna, Kesighat, he took Diksha. From then onward, Guru Pad Padma was missing. Paramahansa Guru Pad Padma was missing. Finally, Gopakumar going to discover Guru Pad Padma in front of Jagannath. Guru Pad Padma shedding tears by looking at Jagannath. That time, Gopakumar was very happy. Gopakumar thought, today I am going to catch Guru Pad Padma. But anyway, I cannot disturb Guru Pad Padma. Anyway, he is going to take darshan of Jagannath with full concentration. Let him take darshan. After darshan is over, when Guru Pad Padma going outside, then I can take darshan. But in the meanwhile, Gopakumar was also, you know, Gopakumar also unmindful, because he was very much interested to take darshan of Jagannath. In the meantime, again Guru Pad Padma gone. He could not trace out. He was very sorry. He was very, very sorry, with heavy heart. With heavy heart, Gopakumar started searching Guru Pad Padma in Purushottam Dham, Nilachal. He started searching Guru Pad Padma. Finally, he could discover Guru Pad Padma alone at the bank of sea, Nilachal Ocean. He could discover Guru Pad Padma alone dancing, singing, and with full ecstatic feeling. Now Gopakumar was very much interested to meet with Guru Pad Padma. He started running and going to fall down in the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, rolling down on ground. Guru Pad Padma going to help. Guru Pad Padma going to help Gopakumar. Guru Pad Padma now going to help Gopakumar to get up. And then Guru Pad Padma embraced him. Guru Pad Padma, that Paramahansa Acharya, Paramahansa Guru, finally going to embrace his disciple Gopakumar, whom he gave mantra long ago at the bank of Jamuna, Kesighat, Vrindavan. He could remember everything. And out of his own causeless mercy, Guru Pad Padma wanted to give some special advice to Gopakumar. That was the last finishing yesterday. I wanted to speak. Gopakumar speaking, my Guru Pad Padma is Sarvagno. Gopakumar speaking that my Guru Pad Padma is Sarvagno. He can see everything, past, present and future. So naturally, he could develop some weakness inside me. Even before I speak something, he started giving advice to me, because all past, present and future, everything known to my Guru Pad Padma, he could realize my heart. Accordingly, he wanted to give me advice. I was very much interested to hear that advice. At the same time, I was planning to take all the procedure of bhajan, how to do all the mystery of bhajan. So anyway, Guru Pad Padma going to give advice. What Guru Pad Padma advice? Guru Pad Padma could realize inside heart. My Guru Pad Padma could realize inside heart that I am going to show some indifferent attitude towards mantra japa. Previously, I was doing mantra japa with full attention. At present, Gopakumar started thinking that I am going to get the final result of my mantra japa. Gopakumar started thinking that anyway I am going to get the final result of my mantra japa, so I am getting darshan of Jagannath in Jamaica. So what use chanting this mantra heavily? So I can do very often, and I can do not so with full, you know, with not like previously. That's why Guru Padma was bound to give me advice, my son, don't think it otherwise. Your mantra japa, my son, don't think it otherwise. Your mantra japa, my son, your mantra japa is nothing but the seva of Jagannath. Oh, really? Yes. My son, your chanting mantra, your mantra japa is just Jagannath Dev Seva. Sri Jagannath Devasya Seva Rupancha Vidditam Evam Matyacha Vishyasya Nakadachit Japam Taji. Never try to stop chanting this mantra. Never try to stop chanting this mantra, or never try to express some indifferent attitude towards your Nam Seva. And you should believe me, as I am going to advise you, you should have full belief in me, my speech. You should have full belief in my advice. So accordingly, it is my advice to you, order to you, keeping 100% faith in my instruction, you never try to stop chanting mantra. Because you don't know the final, you know, if you don't know what is the power of that mantra, supernatural power, aprakita. Tametasya prabhavena chirajivi bhavanyaham idrik goparvarupasya tatphalaptarhamanasa. You don't know the great influence of that mantra. I promise you, by the power of that mantra, you can get chirajivi, chirajivi. You can get long life. And not only that, but also always and every time, I mean in course of time, anyway, you are not going to change your body status. I mean, you can maintain same age, same status of body. It is really impossible. How possible? That I can explain. How possible? Sanatan Goswami going to explain. Tametasya prabhavena chirajivi bhavanyaham. By the influence of that mantra, you can live, long live you can. And forever you can maintain same age, same body status like Gopo Balak, coward boys. And not only that, but also you can meet with the mantra Adhishtati Devata, I mean Madan Gopal. Mantra Adhishtati Devata. You can meet with the mantra Adhishtati Devata of this mantra, I mean Madan Gopal. You can get direct darshan of this Madan Gopal. Prabhu, this mantra can help you to meet with this, you know, Madan Gopal directly, and also all different kind of sporting mood of Madan Gopal. You can understand all different kind of sporting mood of Madan Gopal. You can realize, you can see, you can feel. You can see, you can feel all that kind of aprakita mind. That kind of aprakita mind to remember Ashtakalin Lila is impossible. When my mind is matured enough to see all the Lila Vilas of Bhagavan Sri Krishna inside Vrindavan, that means my mind is aprakita. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Daihiko Visyate Tesam Panchabhuti Dehe Opi Sachidananda Rupata. Sanatana Goswami already wrote it in the first volume. Brihad Bhagavanta, first canto. Already I told. In course of drinking all nectarian Harikatha, Kirtan and Harikatha, gradually you can cut all your link with matter. Body and body related things you can forget. Then you can feel in your life the only object of attraction. The only object of attraction is Krishna. In that case, be sure your mind is aprakita. Body, mind, all become aprakita. Krishna bhakti sudha panat. Krishna bhakti sudha panat. Krishna bhakti sudha panat. Deho daihiko visrite. Tesam panchabhautik dehopi sachidananda rupata. Sachid anandamaya sarir. You can feel that your body no more going to be influenced by maya, no disturbance. Bhagavan is always, you know, with sportive moods. Bhagavan is always, Madan Gopal is always with sportive moods, very exceptional sporting moods. And different kind of joking, playing, you can realize. You can develop that kind of aprakita man. The blessing of Guru Padma, the blessing of Guru Padma is really abnormal. Because by the, you cannot express any doubt in it, because what is not possible by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava? Everything possible. Which is impossible in front of you, that is also possible. You can remember when Hiranyakashipu asking Prahlad, where is your Prabhu? Where is your Prabhu? Bhagavan. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, he is omnipresent everywhere. Hop! Everywhere. Here in this pillar, I can get your Prabhu? Yes, you can get here also. Then Hiranyakashipu wanted to provide a big fist of fury. The pillar was, you know, broken, and from inside the pillar, Bhagavan Nrisimhadev appeared. Can you expect Nrisimhadev to appear from inside your room, inside your, you know, it's possible, because you have less faith. Complete faith you don't have. That day you can develop 100% faith in Bhagavan, same thing can happen in your life. Same thing can happen in your life. 100% belief can help you. So in Bhagavatam it is written about Prahlad Maharaj, about Nrisimhadev. Why Nrisimhadev appeared? It's not possible. But we know from Shastra, Bhagavan is omnipresent. In infinity world, Bhagavan is omnipresent. Only we need 100% faith in Him unto His lotus feet. So in Bhagavatam, 7th canto, it is written about the appearance of Nrisimhadev from inside the pillar. It is written, Satyam vidhatum nijavitta bhashitam. Satyam vidhatum nijavitta bhashitam. His own devotee, Prahlad, Nrisimhadev, Prahlad Maharaj is the devotee of Nrisimhadev. So, Satyam vidhatum nijavitta bhashitam. What Prahlad Maharaj told in front of Hiranyakasipu, that must be 100% perfect. If not perfect, then some doubts and suspicion can arise. So, Satyam vidhatum nijavitta bhashitam. So, anyway, when the Gurudev of Gopakumar going to bless, when the Gurudev of Gopakumar going to bless Gopakumar that way, we can express some doubt in it. But repeatedly I told you what not possible, what is possible now. Not that what is possible, what not possible by the mercy of Sadguru Vaishnava, everything possible. Bhagavan, anyway can help. Bhagavan anyway can help. Bhagavan cannot allow to prove that devotee is speaking lie. Devotee never speaking lie, na. So anyway, he was very interested. So by the blessings of Guru Padpadma, Gopakumar going to accept his blessing. See, it is 100% possible. Why not possible? By the mercy of Guru Padpadma, he is going to believe 100% that he can meet with Madan Gopal. And he can feel all different, he can see, he can feel all different kind of, sportive mood of Bhagavan. Different kind of game, with full curiosity, Bhagavan doing. Out of joking mood, Bhagavan doing. You can see, it is the blessings of Guru Padpadma. First point, yesterday I also wanted to discuss this point. All our secrecy of bhajan, all our secrecy of bhajan depend upon our strong belief in Guru Padpadma. Many times I told one slok written by, spoken by Srinivasa Acharya, Balavan Adaro Jasu Nasat Guru Padambuje. So long as we are not going to develop 100% faith unto the lotus feet of Guru Padpadma, till then, whatever amount of energy we have given to learn Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, Shastra, it has got no meaning. Balavan Adaro Jasu Nasat Guru Padambuje. Sutoi rapi tasya sastrair krishne bhakti na jayate. Without developing 100% faith, without developing 100% faith unto the lotus feet of Guru Padpadma, any amount of energy given by me in learning Ved, Vedanta, Upanishad, Shastra, all useless. Because I cannot get bhakti. It's not possible to get bhakti. So, we can understand that top to bottom, we can understand that from top to bottom of bhajan, everything depends upon the mercy of Guru Padpadma. That we can realize. Without believing, without having 100% faith, unto the lotus feet of Guru Padpadma, nobody can do Krishna bhajan perfectly. Nobody can do Krishna bhajan perfectly. How it was possible for Dhruva Maharaj to reach Dhruva Loka. How it was possible for Dhruva Maharaj to reach Dhruva Loka without, you know, living body, same body? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is a rare case, it is not the usual case. But still, this is one example. So, that Paramahansa Gurudev, Gurupad Padma wanted to bless Gopakumar. That Paramahansa Gurupad Padma wanted to bless Gopakumar. That you need not leave your body, same body, with same body, you can meet with Bhagavan. You can understand all the sportive moods of Bhagavan. You can watch, you can feel, you can get that kind of transcendental body and mind. This is the inner meaning. This is the inner meaning. No? With this material body, nobody allowed to enter into a Prakriti Jagat. But that Paramahansa Guru Padma going to bless Gopakumar this way, so we should not disbelieve. At the same time, I already told, Gopakumar was very much interested to get all in details about the mystery of bhajan. Gopakumar took decision to take all the secret teachings from Guru Padma. Because he had long time he was missing. For a long time he was just missing. Now somehow I am by the mercy of Jagannath, I am going to catch him. So I can learn all in details about this mantra and all mystery related to this mantra. Related to this mantra. But Guru Padma going to speak otherwise. Guru Padma speaking something else. What? Guru Padma speaking, now up to this point I am speaking to you. Because according to situation, according to time, space and matter, though Bhagavan and His Naam and His place is beyond time, space and matter, but still, physically, if we are going to stay in Vrindavan, or mentally, if we are going to stay in Vrindavan, then and only then, it is possible for us to worship Bhagavan Nandanandan Krishna, or Prakita Kamdev. But if I can think Nandanandan Krishna, Aprakita Kamdev, if we can think that Aprakita Kamdev is everywhere, omnipresent, so why not here in Bombay? Why not here in Australia, America, Russia, France, Italy? Why not? This is not good. Because mantra Adhishtati Devata, I mean the devata of that mantra, Aprakita Kamdev and Aprakita Kamgayatri Kambij. You already know from Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is written, we can take shelter of Aprakita Kamdev, we can try to do a bhajan of Aprakita Kamdev, but not fancifully. We can do bhajan of that Aprakita Kamdev by the help of Kamgayatri Kambij. By the help of Aprakita Kamgayatri Kambij, we can also, we can do. Otherwise not possible. At the same time, there is one very vital point. What is that vital point? We know the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mood means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to learn so many bhajan secrecy to us. Aradhya Bhagavan Vajasastaneyasta Dhamma Vrindavanam Ramma Kachitupasana Vrajavati Vargena Jakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prema Pumartha Mahano Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matam Idam Tatradaranapara. So, the slok itself approved by Mahaprabhu It is the Siddhanta Vichar, perfect, approved by Mahaprabhu. Araddha Bhagavan Vajasattanayastha Dhamma Vrindavan. Try to understand. Be careful. It is written, Araddha, whom to worship, Araddha Bhagavan Vajasattanaya. Araddha Bhagavan Vajasattanaya Tadhyama Vrindavan. I mean, in this sloka, it is written, we must worship Nandanandan Krishna. I mean, Yashoda Kindu, or Prakita Kamde. And at the same time, we must worship Vrindavan also. You never try to think, you know, this way. You never wanted to think that way. Because the sloka itself going to give advice. The Araddha Bhagavan, whom to worship? Okay, Krishna. But where? In Vrindavan. Because Aprakita Kamdev, Nandanandan Krishna staying in Vrindavan. If you at least can stay mentally in Vrindavan, then it is possible for you to worship, to do bhajan of Nandanandan Krishna. If you are staying in America, France, you know, physically and mentally, then it is not possible for you. So, it is very much scientific. You should not have any doubt. Mantra Adhishtati Devata should be worshipped in his land, Dhamma. Follow. You should do bhajan of Mantra Adhishtati Devata in his particular Dhamma. You have no right to do bhajan this way, that way. That's why I told you that Mahaprabhu singing Bhuje Shabye Venum Sirasi Sikipicham Katitate Dukulam Netrante Sahachara Kataksham Vidadhate Sadasimade Binda Banavasati Lila Parichayo Jagannath Swami Nayana Pathagami Bhavatume. Mahaprabhu never wanted to worship Nandanandan Krishna, you know, Nandanandan Krishna anywhere. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to worship Nandanandan Krishna with the mood that he is doing bhajan of Krishna in Vrindavan. Otherwise, why is Bhuje Sabya weak? You cannot discover any fruit in the hand of Jagannath. Anyway, there is no hand of Jagannath. You cannot discover leg of Jagannath. You cannot find peacock feather on the head of Jagannath. But everything Mahaprabhu watching. Why? Because Jagannath is Madan Mohan and Mahaprabhu going to worship, going to love Nandanandan Krishna inside Vrindavan. Though physically Mahaprabhu staying there in Purushottam Dham, and we know Purushottam Dham at present equal to Brajadham at present. Due to the presence of Mahaprabhu, we are sure at present Nilachal Dham is equal to Vrindavan Dham, because Mahaprabhu used to watch ocean as Jamuna, Mahaprabhu used to watch Chatak Parvat as Giriraj Maharaj, Mahaprabhu used to look Jagannath as Nandanandan Krishna, Madan Mohan. Mahaprabhu used to watch Jagannath as Nandanandan Krishna, who is embracing Radharani, playing on fruits. Bhuje Sabye Venum Sirasi Sikipicham Katitate Dukulam Netrante Sahachara Kataksham Vidadate সদাশিমদ বৃন্দা বনবসতি লীলা পরিচয় জগন্নাথ স্বামী নয়ন পথগামী ভবতু মে। Whenever Mahaprabhu watching the lotus feet of Jagannath, thinking that Jagannath is Madan Mohan, Nandanandan Krishna, Aprakita Kamdev, every time Mahaprabhu, whenever, during darshan time, Mahaprabhu used to discover Madan Mohan embracing Radharani and playing on flutes. But you and me cannot see. So it is the rules. So it is the rules to do bhajan at least mentally, if not possible physically, or if you physically staying in Vrindavan and if your mind staying in Australia, then it is useless. It is useless. I am not speaking about that. At least physically, you are not able to stay in Vrindavan. You must stay in Vrindavan mentally. If you are successful to stay in Vrindavan mentally, then your Krishna bhajan is successful. That is why Gurudev could realize Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev of Gopakuma, could realize the mood of Gopakumar. That Gopakumar want to know all in details about the secrecy of this aprakita bhajan, but I cannot give it here. I can give inside Vrindavan. That's why Gurudev going to forecast that look my son, মাম দ্রক্ষসি কদাপি অত্র বৃন্দারণ্যে কদাচন এবং স মাম অনুজ্ঞাপ্য কুত্রাপি সহসাগমত। Why Gurupadpadma speaking this way? Gopakumar could not understand in, you know, first hand. Later he could understand. Well, this can be the reason. He was supposed to take all secrecy of bhajan advice from Gurupadpadma. But Gurupadpadma only speaking this much, Mam drakshasi kadapi atru brindaranye kadachano evam sa mam anugyapo kutrapi sahasagamat. Evam, by Gopakumar hearing, Gurudev speaking, Gurudev speaking to Gopakumar. What speaking? Mam drakshasi kadapi atro brindaranye kadachano evam sa mam anugyapyo kutrapi sahasagamat. Gurupadpadma only told me one thing, that my son, sometime you can see me here, sometime you can see me there in Vrindavan. After speaking this, where Gurudev gone, I cannot trace out. Evam sa anugyapo kutrapi sahasagamat. Where Gurudev gone? Oh my God, Gurudev gone anyway. Gopakumar could not understand. The body of Gopakumar, by the blessing, of Gurupadpadma now aprakita. Because without aprakita body, we cannot meet with Bhagavan, we cannot see Leela. Anyway, it is the exclusive kripa. The exclusive kippa of Gurupadpadma on Gopakumar. That Gopakumar can maintain same age and same health status anyway, not going to change, and can meet with, you know, Madan Gopal, because the mantra given mantra given, that mantra Adhishtatri Devota is Madan Gopal, who is staying in Vrindavan. So anyway, Gopakumar could realize, my Guru Padmo not ready to give all in details of bhajan here. Rather, Guru Padmo wanted to advise me that if not physically possible, mentally you must stay in Vrindavan, because without that, this mantra japa, this, you know, all, you know, smaran is not successful, cannot give result. Gopakumar now started crying. Gopakumar speaking, anyway, I was successful to meet with Guru Padma, but finally, I missed my Guru Padma. But anyway, he promised me, sometime I can meet with Guru Padma here in Nilachal Dham, sometime in Vrindavan, so I can keep hope. So I can keep hope 100% that somehow I can meet with Guru Padma. But now at present, due to the absence of Guru Padma, he was feeling separation, a strong feeling of separation. Tad biyogena dinam sanu si jagannatham ikshitum gataha santi maham prapto yatnan chakarabam japi. Tad biyogena dinaha, I was feeling helpless by the separation, a feeling of separation came. Guru Padma gone. Then I took decision to run to Jagannath to take darshan, because who can come out successful to balance my mind? Now I'm feeling disturbance. So I took decision to run inside Jagannath temple to take the darshan of Madan Mohan Jagannath, so that I can, you know, come out of the ocean of misery due to the absence of Guru Padma. Tad biyogena dinaha sano si jagannath mikshitum gataha shanti maham prapto jatnan chakaravam japi. So after taking darshan of Jagannath's smiling face, so I was successful to come out of the ocean of miseries, as I was feeling due to the separation of Guru Padma. And one thing very vital, according to the instruction of Guru Padma, also one very vital thing, according to the instruction of Guru Padma, according to the direct instruction of Guru Padma, I started chanting that mantra with full belief. That was my condition. Tad biyogena dinaha sano si jagannatham ikshitum gataha shanti maham prapto jatnan chakaravam japi. I took extreme care in my mantra japa. I mean nam seva. I wanted to take, because it was the instruction of Guru Padma. Guru Padma told, you should believe my instruction 100%. If not 100%, if there is some shortage of 100%, then you cannot come out successful. That was the instruction of Guru Padma. You can believe me, my advice 100%. Accordingly, you will have to run with your bhajan. That you can do. This way, somehow, I was successful to come out of the ocean of miseries felt by the absence of Guru Padma. Somehow, I could cut my grievance. But one point, very vital point, when Gopakumar speaking, Whenever I used to feel tremendous attraction for Vrindavanam, Brajadham, whenever I used to feel tremendous attraction for Brajadham, that time to get some consolation, I used to look at those forests all around this Jagannath Dham, and after looking, I used to feel that as if I am inside Vrindavan. After looking all around in Purushottam Dham, Nilachal Dham, different forests and sub-forests, so I used to think that as if I am in Vrindavan, just like Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu used to look at Chatak Parbat, and the feeling of Mahaprabhu was that he is watching Giriraj Maharaj ki jai ho. Whenever Mahaprabhu used to look at the ocean, Mahaprabhu used to see as a blue ocean, it seems like Jamuna. All forests, sub-forests, going to give me a feeling, all different sub-forests and forests around Nilachal Khetra anyway, going to give me a belief, strong belief, that I am inside Vrindavan Dham. That was my only consolation. Jadasya darshanot kanta brajo bhume rabhuttaram. Whenever I used to feel tremendous attraction for Vrindavan Dham, that time I used to think that ways to get my mind under my control. Jadasya darshanot kanta brajo bhume rabhuttaram. Tadatu si jagannato mahima spurati smame. Jada asya darshanat kancha brajo bhumer abhuttaram. Tadatu si jagannat mahimna spurati smame. Why? Whenever I was feeling tremendous attraction from brajo bhumi, brajo dham, that time, when I'm going to take darshan of Jagannath and all surrounding fields, you know, forest and sub-forest, Chatak Parvat or ocean, I used to think as if I am in Vrindavan. Jada asya darshanat kancha brajo bhume rabhuttaram. Tadatu si jagannato mahima spurati smame. Tat khetropano sreni vrindaranyo tayarnava. Jamunatveno niladri bhago govardhanatmana. What thinking? Kobukuma speaking. Jadasya ashamin kasha brajadham. Follow. Jadasya darshanat kantya brojo bhume rabhutvaram. Tadatu si jagannato mahima spurati smame. Tat khetropo bano sreni vrindaranyo tayarnava. Jamunateno niladri bhago govardhanatmana. I used to think I am in Vrindavan. That kind of feeling I used to get by watching a Chatak Parbat, the Govardhan Sea, as a Jamuna, and all around different kind of sub-forests and forests. And by watching those, I used to think that as if I am inside Vrindavan, no problem. যদা আশা দর্শনোৎকণ্ঠ ব্রজ ভুবেরভূত্বরম তদা তু শ্রী জগন্নাথ মহিমাস মহিমনা স্ফুরতি স্বামে অল দ্য গ্লোরিজ অফ জগন্নাথ হোয়েন এভার আই ওয়াজ ফিলিং ট্রিমেন্ডাস অ্যাট্রাকশন ফর বৃন্দাবন ধাম হোয়েন এভার আই ওয়াজ ফিলিং আনহ্যাপি Whenever I used to feel unhappy by watching, you know, myself, by watching myself here in Purushottam Dham, not in Vrindavan, I wanted to reach there. But anyway, after taking darshan of Jagannath Madan Mohan, Jada Asya Darshanat Kantha Brajo Bhuvir Abhutvaram তদা তু শ্রী জগন্নাথ মহিমা স্ফুরতি স্বামে হোয়েন এভার আই ওয়ান্টেড টু গো টু বৃন্দাবন বাই দ্যাট টাইম বাই দ্য দর্শন অফ জগন্নাথ আই ওয়াজ ফিলিং কনসোলেশন আই ডিডন্ট থিঙ্ক ইট নেসেসারি টু গো টু বৃন্দাবন দ্যাট টাইম অ্যান্ড স্পেশালি তৎক্ষেত্র অল অ্যারাউন্ড ডিফারেন্ট কাইন্ড অফ সাব ফরেস্ট ইউজ টু গিভ মি আ ফিলিং All different kinds of forest and forest used to, all around Purushottam Dham, used to give me a feeling that as if I am in Vrindavan Dham. Tat khetropubano sreni bindaranna tayarnavaha jamunateno niladribhago govardhanatmana. This way, somehow I could check myself from going outside Nilachal Dham, I mean Purushottam Dham. This way, somehow I could manage myself. I could manage myself. And evam vashan sukham tatro bhagavat darshanat anu. Day by day, in course of my darshan of Jagannath, and also the order of Guru Padma there on me. Guru Padma already ordered me. Guru Padma already ordered me to do japa of that mantra. So I will have to keep strong faith unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma, without which I cannot come out successful. So anyway, also there is a question of success. I will have to shesta siddhi. I will have to get siddhi regarding my mantra japa. Evam basan sukham tatro bhagavad darshanad anu. Day by day I went on taking darshan of Jagannath Madan Mohan, and also according to the instruction of Guru Padma, I went on chanting that mantra daily. Evam basan sukham tatro bhagavad darshanat anu kip guru padab gaya guru padak gaya nittam japami shesto siddhaye sa ishto siddhaye sa ishto siddhaye I mean to meet with the final goal, Ishta Siddhi, I was bound to do because it was the instruction of Guru Padma. So, evam bashan sukham tatro bhagavad darshanat anu, by watching Jagannath every day, every time, I was feeling very happy. And also according to the advice of Guru Padma, I started concentrating in chanting that mantra, specially to get siddhi. Guru Padma told, you can get siddhi of that mantra. And with great happiness, I was staying inside. With great happiness, I was there inside Nilachal Dham. No dissatisfaction, all grievance, all dissatisfaction, all disappeared. In the meantime, once one strange happened. In the meantime, unexpected. What happened? What happens? What happens? Well, an unexpected thing. I mean, the king of Purushottam Dham left his body. Unexpected. Why? King was very good devotee. King was very good devotee. But anyway, atho tasmin maharaje kalam prapte asya sununa jeshtena ati biraktena rajyam ange kritam na tat. Finally, information came to me that the king of Purushottam Dham left body. Oh, really? King left body? So naturally, it is quite natural that all ministers and the family members, they can select king. They said they can select king somebody. So it is the rules. The when king going away from this material world, when any king going away from the material world, if not going to select his son as a king, it is very bad. He will have to select his son as a king. But these rules always 100% not applicable. Like the case of Ben. Anga Raja. It is written in Bhagavatam. When Anga Raj went away from this material world. Material world means he went away from the material world. First of all, he left and went to forest to do bhajan. After that, maybe he left his body. After that, whom to make king? That was the big problem. Because Ben was the only son. But Ben is running illegal way. Ben used to run his life. Ben used to lead his life illegal way. It is not a ruse. So Anga Raj left kingdom with a heavy pain that he could not get one son whom he can elect as king. Even who is not a man. Like a man in an animal. It looks like man, but animal. That was his grievance. So he was very pious man, king. He left. Similarly, what happens? Then all Muni Rishis and ministers, they took decision to elect Benraj as the king. When Benraj was elected as a king, that Benraj is always leading illegal life, avaidha jivan. So naturally, all grievance from different corner of the country started coming. Not only that, but also all Muni Rishis, they are also not feeling satisfaction because he is making disturbance. Benraj going to speak in front of public. Hey, whom you are worshipping? You can worship me. Because king is a god. He wanted to stop worshipping Narayan Krishna. Benraj was very much wicked man. He wanted to put pressure on public to worship his own effigy picture. Hey, you cannot worship me. Why you are worshipping Bhagavan? Bhagavan is, I myself is Bhagavan. Then there was too much disturbance. So Muni Rishis, they wanted to give some advice to Benraj. This is not the way you are thinking. So you must change your mood. Otherwise, big problem can arise. Benraj was very angry by the advice of those Muni Rishis. Finally, there was no alternative. They were there was no alternative but to kill Benraj. They wanted to kill Benraj by fire. Benraj wanted to make some disturbance, fighting with all Rishi Munis. Rishi Muni wanted to kill him by fire. By their darshan, they wanted to make fire and wanted to kill Benraj. So Benraj are gone from this material. Then onward they started thinking whom to make king, because no other son, no other son. Finally, what happens? They started, you know, doing churning, and you know, the leg of Benraj, leg of Benraj. Finally, one very ugly looking. Finally, one very ugly looking tribal man came out. He was very dirty looking. His behavior is very bad, ugly behavior. So finally, when that man asking what to do, then Muni says, "You sit down. You need not do anything. Go outside." They drive him out. So from then onward, all our tribals group, you know, growing. Finally, Muni Rishi also took decision to rub on two hands of Benraj. Finally, Pithu Maharaj came out from the right hand of the body of Benraj by the desire of Bhagavan, and from the left hand, Arshi, Lakshmi. There, the Amsa of Lakshmi coming out. So try to understand many cases there in Bhagavatam. Uttanpad was the elder son of Manu Maharaj. Uttanpad. Priyabrata and Uttanpad. Priyabrata was the elder son. So while Priyabrata was there, it was impossible for Manu Maharaj to allow the younger son as a king. But when Priyabrata left, gone into forest to do bhajan, then what to do? Then finally, Manu Maharaj took decision to make Uttanpad as a king. While elder son is present, it is not the rules to give the throne to the younger boy. Same case I told yesterday, like, you know, Dhritarashtra was not given the kingdom because he was blind due to physical, you know, unfitness. Pandu, the younger son, was given the kingdom. So Pandu used to run kingdom this way. So many documents we can show you. This is the rules. And suppose there is no son, nothing, like at present the case of the king of Purushottam Dham. I am going to speak about the present condition of Purushottam Dham. At present the king of Dibbasingha is a present king who wrote a letter to my Guru Maharaj when 100 years completion of, you know, Utsav was there. He came also physically. He wrote one letter. I was bound to print that letter. Dibbasingha. I also physically have seen him many times when I was there in Brahmapuram. Face to face, he was there in a platform. I was also, you know, there. He was speaking. Bharati Maharaj was there. I was also there in the stage. So this way, Dibbasingha is not actually the son of the previous king. Try to understand. Dibbasingha is not the direct son of the previous king. But anyway, previous king he had no son. Previous king was very sorry. Previous king was very sorry. There was no son in his life. So finally, he was bound to adopt. He was bound to adopt this Dipasinga Rai. I mean, his adopted son. Dipasinga is the adopted son of, you know, a previous king. So this way, so many rules and regulations, I don't like to speak. Here what happens? Gopakuma speaking that finally information, came to me that the king of Purushottam Dham gone from this material world. Ato tasmin maharaje kalam prapte asya sununa jeshtena ati biraktena rajyam angikritam na tat. The elder son of king was not in a position to take the charge of kingship because too much detachment was there inside the heart, of that elder son. He was very much interested to serve Jagannath whole day and night. He was less interested to take charge of this kingship because too much detachment inside heart, feeling too much attraction for Jagannath. So he could not be elected as a king. So finally there is a big problem because elder son is alive. Elder son not gone anywhere. In this condition, nobody can make the younger son as the king of the country. So what to do? They wanted to put an application in front of Jagannath. Prabhu, whom to make king? What is your order? Then Jagannath finally came in dream. Finally Jagannath came in dream and started speaking. Well, you can check up the bodies of, you know, all around you. If you find somebody having the symptom of king, as per Shastra, you can make him king. Well, Jagannath wanted to speak that my devotee is a Gopakumar, is coming from Vrindavan outside, but still you can find all good symptoms in his body. So why not you make him king? It is the instruction of Jagannath. So they started searching Gopakumar and finally they could trace out all the symptoms inside in the body of Gopakumar. So they wanted to obey the instruction of Jagannath to make him king. He was made king forcefully. He never wanted to because he is a great devotee. He is feeling great detachment. So anyway, finally, he was bound to take charge as a king. Atho tasmin maharaje kalam prapte asya sununa jeshtena ati biraktena rajyam angikritam natat. Tatravishiktaha prishtasvanu gaya jagad ishitu samparikshyo maharaja chinnani sachivai raham aham. I was selected by watching all different good symptoms of a king in my body as per the order of Jagannath. They wanted to make me king of Purushottam Dham. Tatra avishikto, avishek mane, they wanted to make me avishek. Avishek. They wanted with mantra, avishek, they wanted to make me king. तत्राभिषिक्तो पृष्ठस्वानुज्ञया अनुज्ञाय अनुज्ञया तत्राभिषिक्तो तत्राभिषिक्तः पृष्ठस्वानुज्ञया जगदीशितुः संपरीक्षो महाराज चिन्नानि सचिवैरहम्। आई वॉज सिलेक्टेड एज अ किंग, दैट वॉज द गिग प्रॉब्लम। दो इट इज द ऑर्डर ऑफ जगन्नाथ, दो इट वॉज द ऑर्डर ऑफ जगन्नाथ, सेम आर्गुमेंट वॉज देयर, सेम आर्गुमेंट। ब्रह्मा वॉन्टेड टू गिव इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिज ग्रैंड सन प्रियव्रत, ओ माय सन, मी आई माई सेल्फ एंड शंकर भगवान, all we are going to obey the instruction of Bhagavan. So what wrong in it? So what wrong in it this way? Same, I can discuss this point next week. Due to internet problem, really I am feeling heavy. Maybe I will have to change the time of Harikatha. I will have to change Harikatha time. I can and arrange Harikatha, because noon time every day, almost every day, I am not feeling happy to speak Harikatha. Excuse me, I am not feeling happy to speak Harikatha. Anyway, today I am going to stop here. So next week, I can give all documents about this, you know, Shastra Siddhanta, whom to make king, how to make king, what is the purpose, and those Niskinchan sadhu, they never want to become king. Because if fire is there in front of you without expectation, anyway you are going to feel some heat. Matter and matter, Mahaprabhu told this, I can discuss this point next week. What is the grievance inside the heart of, you know, Gopakumar? Because he is Niskinchan, Akinchan Bhakta. So I am bound to stop here today, because next Harikatha I will have to run to Mayapur. Benum kananta maravinda dalayotaksham barahava tansam asidambuda sundarangam kandarpa koti kamaniya vishesha sovan govinda madhi purusham tamaham bajami vanchakalpadurusya kibasindu vivacha patitanan pavane bho vashyavyo namun.